I was 16 when it first started happening, and I didn't understand because I was in love. I remember like it was yesterday. I was going on a school field trip to have a beach cleanup day. My partner came over in the morning before she went to school. I was showing her my new jacket that my mom bought me. It was blue with white fur inside. It was perfect. I put it on for her and she said, "Take it off." That I couldn't wear it. It was too girly. I didn't understand. Why did it matter? It was a jacket. I said, "No, I love this jacket." She grew more mad and started to get loud and move into my space. I said, "Take the jacket off now." I refused once again, saying no, a little louder. Before my brain could process, she grabbed me by the jacket and pushed me hard to the floor. I looked at her with tears running down my face. I was so confused and hurt. It never stopped after that. It escalated too. The sad part was, it became a norm, and I found affection in it.
It started with his cheating. Then came the ultimatums. He made me open up the relationship, and in doing so, opened up the exploitation of my own vulnerability. I knew what sexual assault felt like before I even knew it had a name. The day he put his hands on me, I felt like I had done something wrong. I grew up thinking men only strike when you've done something wrong. It was an unspoken lesson I learned and witnessed from the women in my family. His pretty words and pretty lies, the ones that kept me there, started to become nothing more than reminders of who he really was. It took me a while before I could conjure up the word that saved my life. Enough. I had to find the strength within myself to say, I don't deserve this. I had to shut that voice, his voice, up every time I would hear it say that I am nothing. I still struggle with the trauma of that chapter in my life, but I find comfort in knowing that I get to write the rest of my story. If you are a part of the LGBTQA community and are experiencing domestic violence, you are not alone. There are folks out there willing to help. For more resources on how to get assistance, please visit loveisrespect.org.